Hi there. I've got another one of these things I do all the time that other people might not know about that I wanted to share. So if you have a Mac, then you have a little app called Automator. And it's basically an app that you can create different workflows to either kind of resize images or change their file type or add an appendix to the end of a name or change a file name completely. It's particularly useful for making batch edits. So if you've got to make the same change or like add sequential numbers to like a large group of files or images, that's kind of the use case that I have for it most often. So I use the old command space search bar to bring up the app, but you could also go into your applications folder and it should be in there. Search for Automator, and when it first opens, it'll just have this menu bar without any program open. You'll think, did anything open? It did. Go to File, New, and in this case, I actually haven't explored what these other automation options are, but I use this workflow option, so we're creating that today. The first thing I want to do is go into Files and Folders section, and I'm going to ask for Finder items. So my workflow will start by opening the Finder window and asking me to select some files. And in this case, I do want to allow multiple selection, so to select a number of images at once. In this case, I'm also running a photo or image-based action, so I don't need to change the type of these images, but I do want to scale the images. And it's asking me now if I want to add basically a copying step, like do I want to copy the images and then change their size, or do I just want to change the size directly? And in this case, I do want to add that copying step. I want to copy them to a new folder called Smaller Images. So now it's going to ask me for those files. It's going to copy them into this folder and then it's going to scale them. And in this case, I'm going to say maybe 500 pixels. You could also do a percentage, like have them half the size or some other percentage. So that's my automation. And are there any other steps? Ah, yes, I do want to add to the end of the file name, so back under Files and Folder Actions, I want to rename. In this case, I don't need to copy the files because I'm already working on copied files, so I don't need to add the copy step. And in this case, I want to add some text to the end of the file, which is _500x for 500 pixels, or you could do something like _small 500 pixels, and you can have it either after the name, before the name, or you can change the extension. But in my case, I want all of these images to be copied, put in the small images folder, and then renamed with _small after their original file name. The other thing you could do is add sequential numbering if you wanted to batch sort of add, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or there's quite a lot that you can do depending on your use case for it, but mine at the moment is just batching, making them smaller, and then identifying in the file name that these are the smaller files. So the workflow is ready to go. I now press run, and it's basically going to start at the top and go through that workflow. So it's looking at the desktop for those files. In this case, I need to go into my Dropbox photos and new clothes. I select all of these files. Now it's copying them, it's resizing them, makes a cute little noise when it's done. And then if I want to see where these have gone, I'll go, my desktop's not that clean, but I've got a monitor, which means my desktop icons are on the other screen. So if I open up this, I can now see all of those images have that file name appendage. And then if I have a look at one of these, I can see that the dimensions are, yep, by 500. So it's done what I asked it to. if I wanted to use this workflow again in future, I could save and save it to maybe the desktop as make images 500 pixels. And then if I was to save that, it would look like this as like a file that I could then open. So if I close this up and then open that up again in another day, it would have these like same actions, so I wouldn't have to build up that workflow again. I usually just build it for what I need, but it would be probably more efficient if I had the option saved to the desktop. Anyway, that's what Automator can do. It's much easier than, you know, opening up Photoshop and resizing things 50 times, especially if you've got a large batch of images. But the use cases are endless. If you go in and have a look at all the different what those kind of functions are, like what kinds of things it can do, you might find that there's something more useful to you that's not just the image resizing. But that's my fave. Anyway, enjoy. I hope this is helpful to someone who didn't already know what the Automator app is, or that it existed, or how it worked. As always, we would love to get more subscribers. So if this was a cool video and you want to watch our other cool videos, take a look at the channel. And if it's your jam, please subscribe, tell your friends, and help us get to 100 subscribers so that we can actually call the URL of the channel Producing Paradise, as we hope and dream. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. Bye.